What about division? How do we divide fractions? 2 divided by 1/3. What does it mean to divide 2 by 1/3? Well, how many thirds go into 2? Let's draw a diagram. Here's 2 holes. Divide them up into thirds. How many thirds have I got? 6. Interesting, hey? It's 2 holes, and each hole has 3 thirds, so it's 2 lots of 3, which is 6. Dividing by 1/3 is the same as multiplying by 3. Okay, so what's 2 divided by 2/3? How many lots of 2/3 are there in 2 holes? Well, look at the diagram again. Here's 1 lot of 2/3, and here's another, and here's another. That's 3 in total. 2 divided by 2/3 is 3. Don't get confused by the answer being bigger than what you started with. Remember, you're dividing by something smaller than 1, so it's going to go in more times than a whole number would. Shall we try another? 3/5 divided by 4. Well, here's 3/5. Divide that up into 4. What have I got left? 3 out of 20. 3/20. Hang on, that's the same diagram as we were drawing for multiplying fractions. That's exactly the same as 3/5 times 1/4. So dividing by 4 is the same as multiplying by 1/4. If you've learnt the standard algorithm for dividing fractions at some point, this should be starting to ring some bells by now. Let's try another one. 3/4 divided by 1/3. Well, that should be the same as 3/4 times 3. 3/4, 1.5, 2.25. But that method's not going to work for more complex fractions. So let's try it again, going back to the meaning of division. Here's 3/4, and here's 1/3. I need to know how many of the thirds will fit into the 3/4. Well, let's draw on the full grid as usual. 1/3 is the same as 3/12, and 3/4 is 9/12. So the 1/3, 4 boxes at a time, goes into the 3/4 once, twice, and there's 1 box left over. 1 box out of 4. 2 1/4. Let's try that same method on another question. 3/5 divided by 2/7. Here's 3/5, and here's 2/7. Use a grid to divide each of them up into pieces of the same size. We're going to be using 30/5, 5 times 7. Now each 2/7 is 10 pieces. So let's count. 1 lot of 10, 2 lots of 10, and there's 1 box left over, 1 out of 10. 2 1/10. Could we do this without the diagram? Well, let's try writing out what we just did. We drew each fraction with the same denomination, that is, with pieces of the same size. So let's write our fractions with the same denominator, 35. 21 pieces for 3/5 and 10 pieces for 2/7. Okay. Then we counted how many times 10 went into 21. We divided 21 by 10, which we could just as easily write as a fraction, 21 over 10. Write that as a mixed number, and you've got the same answer as we had before. Nice. Let's try that again on the next question. 1/4 divided by 2/3. Okay, let's write them with the same denominator. We'll use 4 times 3, which is 12. So now I've got 3/12 divided by 8/12, which is just 3 divided by 8. 3/8. All right, let's try it on some mixed numbers. All we have to do is convert them into improper fractions first. 2.5 divided by 4/5. Well, 2.5 is 5 over 2. 2 times 5 is 10, so we'll need to use tenths. Does this remind you of addition? 5 on 2 is 25 on 10. 4 on 5 is 8 on 10. Now it's just 25 divided by 8. Well, that's just 3 holes and 1 left over. 3 1/8. 1/3 divided by 1 1/6. Convert 1 1/6 to an improper fraction, 7/6. Now, think carefully. What size pieces should I use to get both of these fractions to have pieces the same size? It's just the same as with addition. I can use the lowest common denominator, which in this case is 6. So, 1/3 is 2/6. Then 2 divided by 7 is just 2/7. If you just use 3 times 6, which is 18, you'll still get the same answer in the end, but you'll be using bigger numbers, and you'll have to simplify your answer by cancelling common factors. I know what I'd rather do. 1 1/4 divided by 3 1/6. Convert to improper fractions, 5/4 and 19/6. What denomination should I use here? What's the lowest common denominator? 12. 5/4 is 15/12. 19/6 is 38/12. So our answer is 15/38.